are very lucky today to have Mr. Mike Field to talk to us about Hull Island and various other aspects of the televisual world. He is an executive with ITV. He heads up Nordic Production, Global Performance, Global Development programs within ITV. His experience is across the world. Not only has he worked at ITV, but he's also worked in various other companies like Planet 24, London Weekend Television, Hattrick Productions, ABC, and with the BBC. Do we mention the BBC? We can. He's been involved in The Chase, I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, Hell's Kitchen, Come Dine With Me, and of course, Love Island. What you're going to hear today will obviously open up some of the information about the Love Island. Mike.
Chances.
What are you doing?
I'm back. It did before. beginning of Psalm 2.
Carl from Strictly Come Dancing, isn't
it? So actually, Love Island is now probably more famous than anybody that was in Celebrity Love Island. So we came up with Love Island, and this is what Love Island is.
Stunning locations, endless sunshine, and gorgeous people in swimwear. People, this is what TV was invented for. It's a rating smash hit. TV Steve says it's social media and significance. This is love. For the benefit of all mankind, we've decided to find out what would happen if you sent a load of sexy singles to paradise.
Just to get interesting.
The answer, TV goes. With our user-friendly Love Island app,
wow.
We dump the dull ones,
wow.
Send in fresh ones,
bring them on board,
a new Island app,
and even matchmake.
Oh my god!
Money shaping's a bitch.
And just as they think they're having the time of their lives, we remind them there's one thing better than true love.
If I see that you're also trying to push under that, it's not going to be good.
And that's a big cash grab.
You cheating on me, then?
Only one couple can win.
Get them on.
Move. Scares me because I'm now in that zone of being able to get hurt.
Before we go in, so we've got something called content show. construct all the interior. We redesign the interior. We move the kitchen outside. These people do not live in out of the kitchens outside. We're constantly pushing the contestants outside. The reason that is because then we can keep them in one place or keep them in control. There's 72 cameras in that villa, constantly watching everything they're doing. There's 273 crew and production team backstage monitoring it. We're constantly filming 24/7 for 7 weeks. As much as they go, they try and hide, they try and whisper, they try and get mics everywhere. They literally cannot get what they're doing. That's the backstage in my village. So we bring in a load of water cabins, and say 273 people have to be out in offices. We run 14 editing suites, so we're constantly editing the shows as we record. They run 24/7, okay, so we're working on shifts, they're running all night. The show is shot one day behind, so Tuesday night show is shot on Monday. So you're turning around the show very, very quickly. Yeah. attention of viewers of mine, both in the news and the end of social media. We use it in different ways to drive the editorial of the show. So, if you can ask your favourite couple there, I'm doing that bit, it wasn't necessary to give them surprise, it was to find out who's really all working there, who's the least favourite couple, so that then we can promote them through and see if that's something they might change. Or we could do a recoupling and change the couple so that you might find them there and give them a sneaky date that you maybe get to know them more. All sorts of different things. But these are a series of bits that show that one piece of information that we're asking for, that one vote. The different ways that we might have used that. I'm trying to use clips that you may remember. But who remembers this moment? The most meaningful moment in the series.
I've got this board of colours. I don't know what's going on there. I think he's got good banter, he's kind-hearted, and he's welcoming. Being a new person, I don't feel the need to play it safe. So for that reason, what I'd like to pop up with is... Ken.
Tonight, two boys will enter the villa.
Yes, we offered you the choice of four boys, two old and two new. Who did you choose?
Hashtag return of the mark. Hashtag play again, sir.
That's fucking mucky.
It's on the way we've considered the environment and decided to recycle.
Oh my god,
fuck that.
Foxy Mark, just
saying. It's not seeing ghosts. Oh my god, it's sick.
Into the villa to create more
sanitise that text from blank to blank, slagging her and Alex off.
Hashtag drama.
Has anyone sent a text about Montana and Alex? Anyone?
Kevin and Olivia?
No, I'm afraid that's not correct. Orange
Kevin and Chris?
I'm afraid that is wrong. So, the answer is... Marcel and Gabby.
Television in general, how you get into that line, and how you get into that line. if you want to know how to get into television, just do this for a living. Then I'm happy to answer any questions.
How do you like narrow down like
people? Well, clearly, mostly on their intellect. We're looking for people. Obviously, there is a physical type to be looking for. We're looking for incredibly good looking people who haven't necessarily got everything, you know, their life all lined up. But what you'll find is most of the people that go in there, boiled it down to a social experiment. These are all alphas in their groups. They're, you know, the alpha male, the alpha female. They're all the top of their group. And when you put 12 alphas in one place, they're constantly mining to find out who's the most important. And you'll see, if you watch the series back again, available on ITV Hub, you can see that they come up, they rise up. So it was Chris and Olivia who sort of became the Uber Alpha in there. So we're looking for outgoing, good looking people who are obviously genuinely looking for love, probably not. But are in dating, you know, they do want to find a partner. So for those who we're probably not the most diverse classmate that we've got to be looking for.
Is there actually a winter one
on the there is a winter show coming. It is announced, I can't tell you. It's called Survival of the Fittest. It's going to be shot in South Africa. It goes on air in February. It's not Love Island, it's not the same show, it's not exactly the same show, but it will hit many of the same beats. In this show, Survival of the Fittest, what happens is you have a team of boys and a team of girls, and they've got to compete in challenges to win prizes. They can either win some prizes for the boys, for themselves, or they can win dates with the girls. So the whole dynamic of that show is do you win a prize for your best mate, or do you want to go on a date? So it will have many of the same things you're going to see. February 12th, ITV2. Don't do that. Mr. Townsend.
Which part generates the most income? Franchising, products, advertising?
Next year will be advertising. We'll see what we'll see because of the success of this year. We generally lag behind on a series. Ratings drop. A following series of the year that drops. So next year we expect to see upwards of £10 million worth of advertising revenue go through that show, which is significantly more than this year. If it goes global, there were a couple of brand companies that were reported during the show's on air. They're predicting up to hundreds of millions of pounds of revenue from this show. I'm not sure we'll get there. That'll be next year, and in two or three years, if the international versions, especially if it goes to America, where my budget is. Or are you just tired?
Yeah. And then it won't try to, like, bring things together.